this shocking sniper bullet can hit any spot directly. Now, no more dodging a bullet, because the US has developed a self-guided ammunition. These guided bullets, developed by DARPA, are a sniper's dream. According to the agency, the technology is so simple to use that a novice shooter using the system for the first time could hit a moving target. So, does this mean smart bullets are the future of precision warfare? Join us as we'll explore the latest development in smart bullets and discuss how they could revolutionize the world of snipers. Smartphones, wearables, and smart scopes are all well and good, but what about smart bullets? Smart bullets will become a reality if DARPA, or the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, has its way. DARPA manages and controls a number of programs aimed at increasing the military's efficiency through technology. They collaborate with universities and other firms to create some truly cutting-edge projects. Since 2014, smart bullets have been on the menu. The concept of guided weapons is not new. Guided munitions have transformed the military into a far more effective and lethal fighting force. TOW and Javelin missiles provide even the most inexperienced soldier with access to guided anti-armor assets. However, reducing guided bombs to bullet size offers a significant problem. There isn't much room to maneuver, but that doesn't rule out the idea. Before we get into that, why would anyone desire smart bullets in the first place? So, what is so special about these smart bullets? If you don't know, don't worry. We'll let you know soon. But before that, please drop your bomb now on the subscribe button and be a member of our exclusive military family. The most obvious response is precision. A guided smart projectile improves the accuracy of each round. The more lethal a weapon, the more accurate it may be. Aside from aggressive combative measures, guided smart bullets can be employed to counter future threats ranging from swarming UAVs to incoming rockets. We already utilize weapons like the 20mm Phalanx CIWS to defend ships against missiles. The usage of smart bullets also has a safety benefit. Yes, I said safety. Throughout the 20-year global war on terror, warfare happened close to or in the midst of civilian populations. Due to the possibility of civilian casualties, troops were forced to utilize their most lethal weaponry. If you have a truck full of bad people, an LAW or AT-4 will take care of them quickly, but the risk of innocent casualties means those weapons are rarely employed. Non-explosive guided projectiles can destroy the threat without putting civilians in danger. Furthermore, projectiles from 50 caliber weapons may travel a long distance while still retaining enough energy to kill. The ability to direct those large projectiles reduces the possibility of friendly fire and civilian mishaps. The disadvantages are obvious. The most important factor is cost. The price of these rounds has not been disclosed, but it is unlikely to be inexpensive. For the time being, these will be specialist munitions rather than standard issue items. Second, the cartridges are quite little. Because it is difficult to incorporate the necessary technology into a standard infantry rifle caliber, guided munitions will be limited to large, powerful platforms such as anti-material rifles. Let's talk about the sniper bullet, which is getting attention in the military world. But wait! Before we get into that, make sure you lock the aim at the bell icon, fire it now, and be a member of our exclusive military family. Now, coming back to the topic. For starters, it's classified, and we don't know if it's being used by American forces, covert or otherwise, somewhere in the world. Second, experts believe this technology has the potential to completely transform the job of military sniper. Finally, consider a bullet to be a self-guided weapon capable of making course corrections in mid-flight. It seems a little weird, but it appears to be a favorite project of the DARPA agency. According to Kyle Mizokami of the National Interest, DARPA, known for financing bizarre and amazing military technology, claims that its Exacto, or Extreme Accuracy Tasked Ordnance, bullets can transform 50 caliber bullets into guided rounds that can focus on a specific target. Although DARPA has not revealed how it accomplishes this, some sites claim that the technology involves optical sensors in the bullet's nose and fins capable of altering the bullet's flight path in the tail. According to the study, the optical sensor appears to zero in on a place lit by a laser designator. The guiding technology is comparable to that of laser-guided weapons like the Maverick and Hellfire missiles. The bullet can even make some very sharp course modifications. Military snipers typically rely on specialized training, accurate, high-powered rifles, and high-quality optics to strike targets that are frequently tiny specks on the horizon. According to DARPA, this technology is so simple to use that during testing, a novice shooter using the system for the first time hit a moving target, according to the story. Exacto technology, developed by Teledyne Technologies in California, provides an advantage over ballistic computer technology. While ballistic computers may transform conventional weapons into precision-guided ones, once the bullet is discharged, the computer is no longer able to help. If the target shifts during the bullet's brief but significant flight time, the shot is lost. Exacto, on the other hand, continues to steer the bullet toward the target to the point where it can engage a moving target, according to the study. DARPA claims that snipers can now attack targets at longer ranges more swiftly and accurately. Sudden environmental changes, such as a gust of wind, have no effect on technology. A guided bullet with the ability to hit moving targets could be extremely beneficial against drones and unmanned aerial vehicles. Exact requirements are assigned, such as range, maximum crosswinds, and how slowly a target must move. DARPA did, however, admit that it is seeking a bullet with the same energy and momentum as current M33 50 caliber rounds at all ranges greater than 300 meters. It would also like that the Exacto system weighs no more than 46 pounds, which is the weight of the present M107 sniper rifle with scope and tripod. The Exacto's power supply should last for 14 hours and be compatible with existing sniper rifles like the M82A1 and M107. It also desired a secure and tamper-proof design to prevent the misuse and exploitation of any portion of the system if obtained by an adversary. But as is typically the case, there are downsides. If Exacto uses a laser designator to mark a target, the laser is visible under certain conditions, warning individuals who are being targeted. Worse, the laser beam will be directed directly toward the person lasing the target. The equipment will also require a long-lasting power supply, as a sniper may have to wait for hours to take a shot. The most difficult aspect of developing a deployable weapon system may be the cost. DARPA desired a weapon that was affordable enough to deploy with the troops. Surprisingly, DARPA has gone silent on Exacto and has not provided any additional information since it was made public. So, is it now in use? Possibly. Experts believe it may have entered classified service with a Pentagon agency, likely the U.S. Special Operations Command. It may possibly have ended up on the DARPA scrap heap as yet another project that proved unfeasible after millions of dollars were spent. First is the Sandia National Labs guided bullet. Sandia National Laboratories began producing its own self-guided 50 caliber bullet. However, this appears to be not only one-of-a-kind round, but also a one-of-a-kind weapon. A laser designator is used to guide the self-guided missile. The laser directs the projectile, allowing the operator to redirect the round or track a moving target. The gun has a smooth bore, and the bullet incorporates an optical sensor, a counterbalancing mass, and stabilizing strikes. Surprisingly, according to Sandia National Labs, the flight test may be carried out using commercial off-the-shelf components. The laser's effective range may be a disadvantage, but this needs to be seen. It may be fun, especially if the laser and shooter are separate. An infantryman with his sights set on the target may designate it for a sniper to eliminate with a laser. Could a single laser direct numerous projectiles? It's intriguing, and it could be a less expensive infantry option. This is not your typical smart bullet, if such a thing exists. That's all for the video today. We'll be right back soon. Have you dropped your bomb on the subscribe button yet? If not, what are you waiting for? Drop it now and be a member of our exclusive military family.